Hey everyone, it's great to see you again. And if you are new to the channel, my name is Bill Benoist. I'm a certified professional career coach here in Silicon Valley. I want to talk a little bit about imposter syndrome today. It's a subject that often comes up in my coaching practice. And what I want to go with in today's video is a little bit different than what a lot of people talk about when it comes to imposter syndrome. Most of the time when you search imposter syndrome, you're looking at ways to fix yourself. How do you address imposter syndrome? How do you get over imposter syndrome? You know, it's something that's holding you back in your career, or you're not getting ahead, or maybe it's just not helping you sleep at night. And I want to touch base on this in a little bit different light. I want to talk about the good that comes from imposter syndrome. Yeah, there's some good out there. In fact, if you do a little research on Google, you're gonna find articles out there in Forbes, in Harvard Review, in Fast Times, in the BBC, all talking about some of the positive things that come about when it comes to imposter syndrome. And one of the big things, and this is what I really want you to think about if you're suffering, if you feel like you're being debilitated by imposter syndrome, my guess is you're probably already pretty successful in life, because this is something that a lot of individuals that suffer from imposter syndrome, just like the study by Dr. Imes and Dr. Clancy, was that it's usually from successful individuals. Now, their study was with women, but over the years, there's been many, many studies, both men and women. In fact, they say that at some point in time, almost 70% of us will at one time or another suffer from imposter syndrome. But if you're really suffering from it, you know, on more or less a consistent basis, and it's probably coming when you're given a new task or maybe you've been promoted to a new position or so, then that's when it really starts, you know, rearing its ugly head. Oh my God, they made a mistake. I feel like a fake. They're gonna find out about this. You know, share a quick story with you. I started in the banking industry way back when I was, I think, 22, 23 years old. Now, I know if you've been watching my channel for some time, you know that I was a vice president of information technology for the last 25 years. But this was going back into the very beginnings of my career. And I started in the banking industry. I started as an entry-level teller. And in about 4.5 years, I actually made it to bank manager. Now, that's what I had set my sights on, was becoming a bank manager. I thought that was going to be, you know, my career of choice back, you know, when I was 22, 23 years old. I wanted to be a bank manager. And I can tell you, the day after, or that night that I got promoted to bank manager, I couldn't even sleep. I was like, oh my God, they have made the biggest mistake promoting me there. Anytime now, they're going to come into the office and they're going to just say, Bill, you know what? We made a mistake. You're really not qualified for this position. You're not doing a very good job with it. And we're just going to bump you back down to, we'll give you the head teller position. I got to tell you, I mean, It was week after week, month after month, this was a thought that kept occurring in my mind. When are they coming to tell me that they made a mistake? At the end of the year, I had gone to a meeting. I didn't even know this was going to happen. And I was awarded Bank Manager of the Year in all of California. Here I am thinking I was the biggest fake that, you know, ever walked the face of the earth, you know, as a bank manager, and I was worried that they were going to take this away, and I actually was awarded Bank Manager of the Year out of, you know, all the offices in California. This is what I'm saying, is that it's not a bad thing. This usually happens to individuals that are high performers, high achievers. They just have difficulty really internalizing their success. Now, how do you get over imposter syndrome? I'll let you go to some other videos on that. But what I do want to talk with you about is that you're not alone in this. As a matter of fact, let me just share some of the well-known celebrities who have came out and said that they deal consistently with imposter syndrome. Tina Fey, Tom Hanks, Amy Schumer, Lady Gaga, Emma Watson, Jodie Foster, Sheryl Sandberg, Natalie Portman, Michelle Obama, and there's many, many more. I know Neil Armstrong out there, writer Stephen King. There's so many individuals that suffer from imposter syndrome. You're not alone in this. I want you to keep that in mind. It's something that happens to all of us, but if it's consistent, my guess is you are an achiever and a success. You just are having trouble internalizing it. So I want to end this video on both a positive and a negative. The positive is this: you wouldn't be where you're at today if it wasn't for imposter syndrome. That's my guess. I mean, you're watching this video because you're probably looking for ways to get past your imposter syndrome, that you feel that it's holding you back, but I believe it's actually what's moving you forward. It's taking you out of your comfort zone and it's challenging you, and that's a good thing. And employers like that, companies like that, and my guess is you're a lot more respected than what you are. You believe you are. That's my guess, because this is what I see with people that feel that they're an imposter in the position that they're in. The negative, though, however, is that it's also probably causing you a lot of stress in your life, and that's what I want you to I want you to think about this, is that it's a good thing and not a bad thing. So there's really nothing to be stressed out about. Sure, it's going to last, but it's what's challenging you. It's what's making you who you are today, and that is a successful person. So I hope you found this video informative and useful, and if you haven't already done so, make sure that you subscribe to this channel, hit that bell notification, because I do upload new career tips and strategies every Tuesday, and I'd hate for you to miss anything. Thanks for stopping by, and I look forward to seeing you next week. Take care.